Real forgiveness is the humble willingness to recognize and accept the imperfection, the fallibility, and the woundedness of human being. Every day we judge ourselves and others for not living up to our standards, for not behaving in the way we would like, not doing what we think they should be doing. We blame others for unsettling our equilibrium, obstructing us in some way and causing us discomfort. Common humanity, and it recognizes what is of real value.
Thank you. As this is a self-hypnotic recording, it should never be played whilst driving or at any other time when you need to maintain full awakening consciousness. Okay, let's begin. When you are ready to begin, I want you to place yourself into a comfortable position, either sitting or lying, legs and feet uncrossed and slightly apart, hands resting loosely in your lap. And let's begin with your breathing. I'd like for you to take some long, slow, deep breaths and fill your lungs with air. Then hold that breath for the mental count of three. And as you slowly exhale all the air from your mouth, just think in your mind the words deeply, deeply, deeply relaxed. So let us begin. Breathe in, hold for three, and breathe out. Breathe in, hold for three, and breathe out. Breathe in, hold for three, and breathe out. Good. And when you breathe in, imagine that you're breathing in calmness and relaxation. And when you breathe out, just breathe away any tensions or anxieties or any worries that you may have. And feel the physical body beginning to relax. Begin by relaxing the eyes. Those tiny muscles around the eyes. Let them relax. Let go. If they are not already closed, you might like to gently close them now. Perhaps even a slight fluttering there, as it takes no effort at all to allow them to close. There's absolutely nothing for you to do but relax. And it's a wonderful feeling to know that there's nothing of any importance for you to do. Nobody wants anything. Nobody needs anything. Enjoy the wonderful feeling that is growing and developing within you now. Relax. Let go. Let
Thank you. To use words but rarely is to be natural. Hence, a gusty wind cannot last all morning, and a sudden downpour cannot last all day. Who is it that produces all these? Heaven and earth? If even heaven and earth cannot go on forever, much less can man. That is why one follows the way. A man of the way conforms to the way. A man of virtue conforms to virtue. A man of loss conforms to loss. He who conforms to the way is gladly accepted by the way. He who conforms to virtue is gladly accepted by virtue. He who conforms to loss is gladly accepted by loss. He who tiptoes cannot stand. He who strides cannot walk. He who shows himself is not conspicuous. He who considers himself right is not illustrious. He who brags will have no merit. He who boasts will not endure. There is a thing confusedly formed, born before heaven and earth. Silent and void, it stands alone and does not change. Goes round and does not weary. It is capable of being the mother of the world. I know not its name, so I style it as the way. I give it the makeshift name of the great. Being great, it is further described as receding. Receding, it is described as far away. Being far away, it is described as turning back. Hence, the way is great, heaven is great, earth is great, and the king is also great. Within the realm, there are four things that are great, and the king counts as one. Man models himself on earth, earth on heaven, heaven on the way, and the way on that which is naturally so. The heavy is the root of the light. The still is the lord of the restless. Therefore, the gentleman, when traveling all day, never lets the heavily laden carts out of his sight. It is only when he is safely behind walls and watchtowers that he rests peacefully and is above worry. How then should a ruler of 10,000 chariots make light of his own person in the eyes of the empire? If light, then the root is lost. If restless, that the Lord is lost. beautiful as the beautiful. Yet, this is only the ugly. The whole world recognizes the good as the good. Yet, this is only the bad. Thus, something and nothing produce each other. The difficult and the easy complement each other. The long and the short offset each other. The high and the low incline towards each other. Note and sound harmonize with each other. Your name or your person, which is clearer? Your person or your goods, which is worth more? Gain or loss, which is a greater pain? Thank you.
Thank you.